Welcome back to Java Tutorials for Beginners. In this tutorial, we are going to learn more about inheritance in Java with demo of Java program. Inheritance is one of important object-oriented programming principles in Java. Let's see video objective. In an object-oriented language like Java, inheritance has ability in Java for one class to inherit from another class. In Java, this is also called extending a class. One class can extend another class and inherit properties from that class. Let's move on to more about Java inheritance. In an object-oriented programming language like Java, we create objects and classes. When one class inherits from another class, the two classes take on certain roles. It is an effective way to reuse code between classes. Java provides a keyword called extends for inheritance. The class that extends is the subclass, and the class that is being extended is the superclass. Inheritance follows class hierarchy approach. When a class inherits from a superclass, it inherits parts of the superclass methods and fields. The subclass can also override the inherited methods. In inheritance, a subclass is a specialization of a superclass, and a superclass is a generalization of one or more subclasses. Example, there is a superclass named Vehicle and a method called Hung. The subclass named Car, which extends the Vehicle superclass, and after extending the superclass, there is a creating constructor and Hung method is called. Then attribute values are displayed using myCar object. When you run this program, the output is displayed from the method from superclass Vehicle. Let's discuss about the important points of inheritance. In a subclass, you can override methods defined in the superclass. To override a method, the method signature in the subclass must be same as in the superclass. Otherwise, the method in the subclass will be considered as separate method. But we cannot override private methods from the superclass. Constructors of a superclass is not inherited by the subclasses. Subclasses can still call the constructors in the superclass using the superconstruct, and it should be the first action in the constructor. If you don't want the other classes to inherit from a class, then use final keyword. We can't extend final classes. We can use instance of keyword to check inheritance between objects. The private members of superclass are not directly accessible to subclass. We can see different inheritance types for code reusability. First type is single inheritance. When a class extends just another class, then we call it as a single inheritance. Multi-level inheritance refers to a mechanism in which one can inherit from a derived class, thereby making this derived class as base class for the new class. Hierarchical inheritance is when one class is inherited by many subclasses. Hybrid inheritance is a combination of single and multiple inheritance. Multiple inheritance refers to the concept of one class extending more than one base class. Both hybrid inheritance and multiple inheritance are implemented using interfaces. Let's see the main rules of inheritance in Java. When a class implements an interface, it has to provide implementation details for all the methods of that interface. When an abstract class implements an interface, it's not required to override methods of the super interface, but the first non-abstract class in the inheritance tree must override the methods. Subclass inherits all the public and protected members of the superclass. When an interface extends another interface, the subinterface inherits all the methods declared in superinterface. In a class, we can inherit both an interface and a class directly. Multiple classes extension to a subclass is not allowed in Java, but Java allows multiple inheritance between interfaces as methods in interface does not have complete methods. Java compiler makes the class inherit object class when you call it. Let's see different inheritance implementations in Java. First one, class implementing interface. In this example, interface name is animal. Just click on the animal interface, we can see there are two methods, eat and move. In dog class, it implements the interface animal. Here in this class, we need to implement all methods in the interface animal. You can have additional methods like var in this class. Let's run this program and we can see the output. Let's see the next type of inheritance implementation in Java, that is abstract class implementing interface. In this abstract class implementing interface, we can see there is an interface named position and there is an abstract class called car. In the interface named position, we can see there are three methods, start, stop and move. But in the abstract class car, it implements the position interface, but it doesn't has three methods. It only has two methods, start and stop. Let's see the next type of Java inheritance is class extends class and implementing interface. In this, we can see an example. There is an interface named position. In this interface, we can see a method named move. And there is another class car. In this, we can see there are two methods, start and stop. Another class named Tesla. In this, it extends the car class and it's implementing the position interface. Here, we are implementing the method move from position interface.
Let's see inheritance in nested classes. Nested classes with the default access modifier are only accessible to subclasses if the subclass is located in the same package as the superclass. Nested classes with the protector or public access modifier are always inherited by subclasses.
Thank you for watching our video. Please stay tuned for upcoming Java tutorials.